Welcome back to our ongoing how-to series on creating iExtend Connect applications. In this video, we will cover two of the new features released with Connect version 1.6. First, Syslog Support. We will configure Connect to listen to a Syslog source and receive Syslog messages by leveraging the Syslog plugin. Next, we will configure our sample Connect app to store and save IOC information into the Forescout platform from third-party sources. In this case, we'll assume the syslog message contains the IOC information that we want to send. To get started, let's look at the steps required to configure the Connect app. First, we want to ensure the iSight appliance is already receiving the syslog messages from the source you want to monitor. We'll add a panel to the system.conf file to define the syslog source. Third, in properties.conf, we'll add a couple things. First, we're going to add a property to associate the receive syslog message with a particular endpoint. And we're also going to add a syslog script entry that will run when a message is received. Fourth, we'll actually create the Python script that will run when the message is received. And once we have ensured that syslog is working properly, then we'll assume that IOC information is contained in that syslog message, and we'll return IOC information back to the IOC Scanner plugin. All right, let's get started with step one. We want to ensure that we're receiving syslog messages already. In this case, I've gone to Options, the syslog module, and here you can see that I am receiving from my first syslog source, which is a Global Protect VPN event. Those VPN events are being sent from the IP address 10.80.100.1. So keep that in mind, we're going to use that later. Next, let's take a quick look at the code. I'm now in system.conf inside the Connect app. You can see that I have defined a panel. It is a syslog source panel, so it's set to true. We've given it a title and a description. This will show up when we install the app and we configure it for the first time. Moving into properties.conf. As you can see, I'm adding a property here, connect syslog test syslog message. That will hold our syslog message that comes back once we receive it. We're going to just add it to the endpoint as a property for this example. Still in properties.conf, we need to add an entry for the script that will run. In this case, I've named it syslog test underscore syslog.py, and it is a syslog message, so we've set that to true. And the final step will be to build our Python script that will handle the syslog messages as they come in. So I've added logging info. You can see that in the output logs on the iSight appliance. We'll look at that in our example. So we're doing a beginning and end to log the info. We're then checking for a parameter connect syslog message. That will contain the syslog message that is received from the remote source. We'll set the variable syslog message equal to that. We also set an IP address. We're setting it statically for the purposes of this example, but you would normally parse that from the syslog message itself. Then we simply create the properties dictionary with the property set to the syslog message. We're then just going to log it so we can see what it said. And then we'll return our response, returning both the properties dictionary and the IP address itself. Quite simple, and let's see it in action. All right, now that we've created our application and we've zipped it up, we now want to import it and install it into Connect. We'll go to Options, we'll select Connect. We will do an import and locate the zip file that we created, syslog test. Now it'll load itself into the system. It's verifying all the scripts. Once it's done, we'll do configuration. So we're going to add an entry. This is a placeholder for perhaps a remote site that we want to work with. So I'm just putting something in here to create a placeholder. Then we'll go to next. This is where we assign our counteract device. If we have a proxy, we can define it here. And this is the key one. We're going to use a syslog source. And you recall from the previous entry that our source was 10.80.100.1. So we know that was already working, so we should be able to receive those syslog messages, I won't enable host discovery at this time and we'll hit finish. Once you've done that, we need to apply. And now we're ready to go. All right, recall from our code that the device we're going to send back statically is 1080-6654. And you can see that we don't have it here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to step over to another machine, which is going to log in from a VPN. It is now connecting. And you can see that 54 has suddenly reared its head. Let's give it a moment to process. And here you can see the property that we created and the value of the syslog message that was received. So it looks like it's working. All right, now we're looking at the output from the Python server log that's inside the appliance. Recall we had logging info for the start and end of the script, and so we can see those messages in here, beginning and end of the script. We were also debugging on the syslog message itself, so we can see that the value started with 14 here, September 3rd, and the date, and so on. Then we can see the properties themselves. And so we're only returning one, but it's connect syslog test syslog message, and it's set equal to the value of the syslog message from above. And that's why we're seeing it on the endpoint. So recall from our debug, we did see the start and stop syslog messages for the script. We did capture the syslog message that was being sent to us from 1080.100.1. We set a property to receive that value, the value of the syslog message, and we saw that at both in the debugs and on the endpoint. So syslog is working. So next we're going to look at IOC scanner support. That syslog message could contain IOC or indicators of compromise information that we want to pass along to the IOC scanner. Now parsing the syslog message and pulling out the IOC information, I'll leave that to you as a Python exercise. But basically what you have to end up with is a dictionary for the IOC information. And in this case, I've set it statically so you can see that I have the IOC info dict sub name equal to bad news, the file name equal to host, a file hash and a hash type of MD5, as well as the severity of critical. And then we simply set the response key of IOC equal to the IOC information dictionary. Once we've done that, that will be returned also in the debugs, and we'll see that IOC show up in the IOC scanner. All right, I have reloaded my application, I've added the IOC information to the script, and now I'm looking at the debug log. And here you can see we have an IOC key entry with a name equal to bad news, a file name equal to hosts, and a hash, and so on and so forth. So that information is making it into the debug and should be making it into our IOC scanner. All right, back to our iSight appliance. We're going to open our options and look for our IOC scanner plugin, which we have here. And within the repository now, we can see that we do have a new IOC. It was reported today. It was reported by the connect syslog test plugin that we created. The thread name was bad news. The file name was host. It has a file size, file hash, etc. So you can see that information is now making it into the IOC scanner from a third-party syslog message. That about wraps it up. Hope you enjoyed this video and will join us for many more to come. If you have further questions, please don't hesitate to contact your Forescout sales team.